back in the Netherlands, and more precisely, in the northern part of Holland, to visit the city of Den Helder. This is the home of the largest Royal Netherlands Navy base, and naturally, the Navy Museum. Naval warfare is usually one of the most secretive, and this Navy Museum has several artifacts related to our content. Welcome to Spy Spots. This museum belongs to the Royal Navy of the Netherlands and is open to the general public, operated by the Royal Defence Museums Foundation. It's a very large museum that will likely take most of your day to properly visit it. It includes ships, interactive and non-interactive exhibitions, shows, and many other things. For the sake of our series though, we'll focus on a few espionage-related artifacts that you can also find there. Clearly, this is by no means a comprehensive presentation of this museum. It's a tiny part of it that we saw during our visit. Like this World War II German Enigma machine. Specifically, its label says, in 1931, the Royal Dutch Navy purchased machines for enciphering and deciphering secret messages. The German armed forces themselves also used the machines during the Second World War. The British Military Intelligence Service, as well as the British Special Operations Service, trained secret agents and radio operators, signalers, for intelligence operations. Knowledge of all kinds of code systems was part of the regular curriculum. By breaking German military codes, British intelligence services were able to decode secret telegrams sent between German military staff. In addition to this intelligence, the Allies needed on-the-spot reconnaissance of German military activities. The intelligence groups, which were operated by secret agents in occupied territories, served this purpose. And in case you wonder why the references to the SOE, well, right next to this Enigma cipher machine, you can find this. This is an original British clandestine spy radio set, the Type 3 Mark II. It was developed in 1942 by the then Captain John Brown at SOE Station 9 and manufactured by the Radio Communication Department of the SOE at Stonebridge Park. So now you probably get the previous reference. There are more artifacts related to our content which you might like too. Like this aerial surveillance camera, where the label says, although the atomic bomb was the most feared weapon of the Cold War, humanity was spared the use of such a weapon during this period. The certainty that one superpower would destroy the other in the event of a nuclear attack brought with it a certain security. To maintain this balance, both sides needed to have data demonstrating the strength of the opposite side. Naval intelligence was obtained, among other things, by photographing Warsaw-packed ships in the open sea. One of the most impressive artifacts of the museum is in the Cold War exhibition, where we have an entire three-cylinder submarine of the Patvis-class. The Tonijn, which was operational from 1966 to 1991, basically almost the entire Cold War period. As we read in its label, the main task was defense against Soviet submarines. The invisibility and noiselessness of these submarines made the three-cylinder submarines very suited for data collection on Warsaw-packed ships. To this end, secret patrols were frequently conducted in the northern Arctic Sea and in the Mediterranean. In other words, this was a Dutch spy submarine from the Cold War, which you can actually enter and see with the help of a guide that provides additional context as you are walking through it. From the torpedo room and the torpedoes, the officers' quarters, sonar cabin, or the submerging room, very related to our content, this is the communications room, and going back to the kitchen and mess hall, as well as the rest of the submarine. There is also a battleship bridge mockup that includes the typical surveillance and communications equipment that those vessels had at the time. One of the biggest highlights here is that you can also get a closer look inside the radar dome from a Tromp-class guided missile frigate, the Router and Tromp, who got their nickname Koyak from this characteristic dome. This 3D radar was operating at 20 RPM, weighted 3.5 tons, and had a range of 390 km with the ability to track over 100 targets as small as a square meter in diameter simultaneously. It was operational from 1975 and until 2000. Moving through the museum, you'll come across even more rare and unique artifacts. Like this. That's an NSA-designed TSEC KL-7, a rotor-based cipher machine which was used by the United States and from 1956 all NATO members too for secure communications certified to handle up to top-secret information. It was invented in 1949 and remained operational until the early 80s. Eventually, it was declassified in 2009. It had two codenames, POLLUX for the low-level traffic and ADONIS for the high-level traffic. There are several interesting spy stories of how, primarily the Soviet Union, compromised it, but those need their own episodes. Other artifacts related to our content include this Linhof camera next to this recorder, an actual CWE-610 sonar transducer, a Decca radar unit, various components from radar systems, and some not so well-known systems like this hammer box, which was sending out acoustic waves underwater in order to detonate acoustic mines. All of that is only a very small subset of everything that you can find in the Navy Museum in the city of Den Helder. And don't forget to also take a walk in the city itself. Most military museums include some espionage-related artifacts, and this was no different. From World War II to this day, naval intelligence is a crucial capability for almost all nation states. It's a secretive type of warfare that we rarely hear about, and museums like this ensure that those will not be forgotten. Each and every of those artifacts is an entire chapter of the modern espionage history that should act as a reminder that nothing is as it seems.